म्यूट பண்ணு, म्यूट பண்ணிட்டியா? So good morning everyone. Good morning everyone. Welcome. This is Dinesh Gajendran from Audacious Dreams Foundation, who is the hosting and moderating partner for Maradhar Kasari Jain College for Women. Today we're going to have the session on webinar on how to write an effective research article organized by IQAC and Research and Development Cell of Maradhar Kasari Jain College for Women, Vaniyambadi, Tamil Nadu, India. So we have our chief guest today, Dr. J. Srinivasan, the Associate Professor and Research Supervisor, PG and Research Department of Commerce, Rajeshwari Vedachalam Government Arts College, Chengalpet. So on behalf of IQAC and Research and Development Cell of Maradhar Kasari Jain College, so we welcome you all for the wonderful webinar on how to write an effective research article. I'm sure everyone is in the pandemic period, so you've been preparing to face the future world. So learning is always a lifelong opportunity. So lifelong learning will help you to improve your potential and opportunities. So without further delay, I'm just inviting Dr. Inbavalli, the Vice Principal and IQAC Coordinator, the QC Coordinator of the Maradhar Kasari Jain College for Women, to give the welcome address.
Good morning to all. On behalf of Maradhar Kasari Jain College for Women, Vaniyambadi, I welcome you all for the webinar on how to write an effective research article. On behalf of IQAC and R&D Cell, it's my privilege of welcoming our distinguished resource person, Dr. J. Srinivasan, Associate Professor and Research Supervisor, PG and Research Department of Commerce, Rajeshwari Vedachalam Government Arts and Science College, Chengalpattu. I welcome you and thank you, sir, for your acceptance and being with us to share your knowledge to enhance our skills. Thank you, sir, once again. We are so pleased to have colleagues, professors, research scholars for this webinar from various institutions. Your strong support and active participation have made the program a valuable one. Pleasure in welcome you all. I also extend my welcome to our secretary, Sri C. Litmichand G. Jain, and other trust members in absentia. I'm delighted in welcoming our principal, Dr. T. Balasubramanian. I welcome you, sir. I'm glad in welcoming Madam PRO and organizing committee members who are the one who made all of us to join in a common platform, and head of departments and faculty. Welcome you all. Also, I'm happy to welcome all our technical team. Welcome you all. As per Henry Ford, anyone who stops learning is old. Anyone who learning stays, continuous learning stays young. So keep learning always, for being young always. Wish you all the best to have a happy and great learning journey. Once again, I welcome you all. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Inbavalli, the Vice Principal of Maradhar Kasari Jain College, for giving your inaugural address and welcome address. And I request Dr. T. Balasubramanian, the Principal, the Honorable Principal of Maradhar Kasari Jain College, to take over the session.
Honorable Management, absentia, distinguished Chief Guest Dr. J. Srinivasan, Associate Professor and Research Supervisor, Rajeshwari Vedachalam Government Arts College, Chengalpattu, dear colleagues of Maradhar Kasari Jain College for Women, dear participants from various parts of India, good morning, one and all present here. First of all, I thank our management for giving opportunity to conduct this international webinar on how to write an effective research article. Writing of a research paper is the first process of the research that will help in several ways. Understanding your subject, formulating ideas of your paper, developing a thesis statement, speaking about your topic with authority. An outline will help you organize your thoughts before you dig into the writing process. Craft a strong opening sentence that will engage the reader. Through research, thoughtful organization and presentation, and attention to detail in your developmental and final line edit will help you succeed in crafting a winning research paper. I thank our resource person for accepting our invitation amidst his busy schedule. I convey my heartfelt wishes to the head and staff members of IQAC and Research and Development Cell of Maradhar Kasari Jain College for Women for their tireless effort for organizing such wonderful gathering. I hope this webinar gives you all knowledge about to how to write an effective research article. I convey my best wishes to all the participants. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Balasubramanian, for your warm introduction. And I request Ms. Astalakshmi, the IQAC coordinator, to introduce the chief guest.
I am Astalakshmi, IQAC coordinator. Good morning to all. Hearty welcome to all to this wonderful webinar on how to write an effective research article. I thank our management, principal, vice principal for giving us an opportunity to organize this webinar and introducing our chief guest. Dr. J. Srinivasan is an associate professor, research supervisor of PGM Research Department of Commerce of Rajeshwari Vedachalam Government Arts College, Chengalpattu, Tamil Nadu. Professor J. Srinivasan possesses 23 years of teaching experience. Sir has guided 11 PhD scholars and awarded PhD degree and a 17 MPhil degree. Now, Professor is guiding 6 PhD scholars and has written 3 books, namely Human Resource Management, Organizational Behavior, Financial Management, published by Vijay Nicole Imprints Private Limited, Chennai. Sir has undertaken major research project funded by UGC worth ₹7,65,000 from 2016 to 2018 and undertook minor research project funded by Tamil Nadu State Council for Higher Education worth ₹1 lakh in the year 2017 and 18. Sir has published 25 articles at national and international level. Sir has presented many papers in international, state level, national level seminar, conferences, etc. Sir has also given many guest lectures. Sir was the academic council member of Tiruvallur University from 2009 to 12 and academic council member of Islamia College from November 2019 onwards. Sir is member of Board of Studies for UG, PG, MPhil courses in DKM College Varuman, Vellore, in Muthurangam Government Arts College, Vellore, STNB Vaishnava College Varuman, Chennai. Today, we have such an eminent personality among us to speak about how to write an effective research article. Sir, on behalf of our Mother Kesar Jain College for Women, we extend our warm welcome to you, sir. Thank you for the opportunity given. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you so much for your wonderful presentation, ma'am. And we have our eminent person, the eminent person who has been well-versed in the research field for the last few decades, Dr. J. Srinivasan. So he'll be handling the next 1 hour session on research, and he has done a lot of homework to empower the audience over here today from the research scholars, the faculties and students from across India. Dr. Srinivasan for the session. Yeah, Dr. Srinivasan. Yes, sir. You're not audible yet. Hello, sir. No, you're not audible yet. No, sir. No, not yet. You can unmute yourself. Now.
Now it is?
Yes, it's fine. It's fine and good.
Yeah. So very good morning to all. It's my pleasure. Now it's audible?
Yes, fine.
Yeah. It's my pleasure to present the topic, how to write an effective research article. Dinesh, audible?
Yes, sir. Very well. You can proceed,
yeah.
Please.
Yeah. Now, before going to the topic, what I have taken for today's discussion, this is my This is my agenda today. We are going to discuss about the introduction part. What are all the personal reasons for writing research article? It's okay now?
Yes, you are good to go, sir. You need not to worry. If there is any problem, I'll inform you.
Okay.
So I'm just listening. Yeah.
And what are all the personal reasons for writing research article? And what do you mean by UGC Care Literature Journals link? What is the procedure for submission of the new journal titles to the UGC? And we are very much focusing on structure of a research article. And how to select the journal for submission. And how to submit the article for a journal. And what is the role of the editorial board while reviewing your paper? And whether the article accepted or rejected or revision, what are the things we have to do? And regarding the authorship and many more questions regarding our topic today. Now, you see that so many reasons we have for writing the research articles. So you have to get a PhD degree. We need some minimum one or two papers before getting a PhD degree. And somebody may get funding based on your project or based on your article. Somebody get a promotion from assistant professor to associate professor level or professor level. There are so many other reasons. In addition to that, we have so many other personal reasons to write an effective research article, to write an article. So personal reasons drive you to publish an effective research article, which demands innovative and creative input for the target audience. We have to give the innovative and creative input for the target audience. So we have these personal reasons, but we have, but as far as our publisher is concerned, they have a set up team, say for example, editors, reviewers, and the research community. They won't consider about your personal reasons. So they want quality papers. They want innovative papers. And now it is writing an effective research article may seem to be a difficult task for the beginners, particularly the research scholars, young teachers, because there are so many questions will arise, how to write, how to start even, how to start, how to write, how to, what format we have to use, which journal we are going to send our journal. If there is any changes suggested by the reviewers or the editors, how to accept it in a positive manner, and what to expect after sending the article to a journal. So we have sent the article to what time, what is the time limit or what's the time frame we have to wait to get published. So these are all the things in our mind, particularly to the youngsters. So before starting to write an article, first you have to select the journal where we are going to send your article. So that is very important thing and first thing, because your subject and the target audience is very important and to select the article. Because if you are related to commerce and management, you can select the journals which are purely related to the commerce and management, or even sometimes now interdisciplinary research is initiated by the UGC and many higher educational forums are doing or encouraging or initiating the interdisciplinary research also. So it all depends upon you. So what type of journal you have to select. So for that, better you go to instruction to authors or guide for authors. So for example, I have given one link, Elsevier, and we have the guide for authors, and you go through the first the content, what is in that. Then only you can proceed further. And one more important aspect in the latest development from the 2018 onwards, the UGC is taking a lot of efforts. They have formed a consortium called Consortium for Research Ethics, that is called UGC CAT. So this is the website what I have given the link. So we have two types of journals. If time permits, I will elaborate in this UGC CAT list of journals in the question and answer session also, if time permits. We have group one and group two. So journals found qualified through UGC CAT protocols will come under group one. And in the group two, journals indexed in globally recognized databases. So in the globally recognized means we have so many databases. Say for example, I'll give the points here. One is indexed in Corpus. Another one is Web of Science. In the Web of Science, we have so many classifications. And journals indexed in Scopus and are Web of Science are part of the UGC Catalyst Group 2. And in the Group 1, it is journals found qualified through UGC CAR protocols that I will explain. And it is the UGC CAR list of journals shall be updated every quarter. So you have to go through and find out whether the selected journal is in the list. So why I am emphasizing this UGC CAR list, why you have to publish and why you are very particular about the journal before going for public, before writing an article or before going for selecting the journal. So now it is mandatory. So you have to publish your journal in the UGC CAR listed journals. So then only it will be a credit. So we have so many other types of journals. Even we have regional or state level or institutional journals. Of course, we will give the weightage according to their, what we can say, research scholars, they can publish their articles through their college-based journals or state-based journals, etc. with the impact factor. But now UGC, they are following certain protocols or norms or procedures to list. These are all the qualified journals. The research scholars or the professors or the assistant professors can publish their articles. So this is for your information I'm updating. Now, this is a process for submission of new journal title to UGC CAR listed journals. It is not our part, but they are doing some procedures, how they are following their norms to select the journals. So submission of new journal. So this is about the submission, not about the submission of article. It is about the submission of new journal. So either publisher can go and approach the UGC or the individual can go and approach the UGC. So two types of information we have to give. So that is the UGC CAR protocol one. So once this step is over, then IQAC cell of any college or university will monitor or will scrutinize your paper and send the proposal to the UGC. At present, I will explain about the UGC CAR list. Then IQAC cell of the UGC CAR universities. We have the set of universities to take care of this process. South, North, Southern region, Northern region, Eastern region, and Western region. So each regions, they have assigned one task. And based on that, they are using it. And which university? One university has given the task of monitoring that cell, UGC CAR listed journals. Then it will go to UGC cell for journal analysis, protocol three. That is the third one. And fourth one, it will be get the approval from the empowered committee. And finally, your journal will be in the UGC CAR list. So this process is available. It is a Pune-based university is given the task. Now, so we'll discuss in, if time permits, we'll discuss about the UGC CAR listed journals and the question and answer session. Now, coming to the main topic, what I have taken today for discussion. So how to write an effective research article? Why I use the word effective, but many students or research scholars are writing research article. And of course, we have conceptual paper, we have research papers. So we are very much focusing on the research article. So what should be, what will be the structure? Now, the first and the primary area, no? Title, abstract, and keywords. These three are very important. In addition to that, you can add one more thing, authors or author. And in the main text, we have introduction, methodology, results, and a discussion. This is the second part of your article. And in the third part, we have conclusion or conclusions, acknowledgements, references. And if you want to add any supplementary data or tables or graphs, etc., or it should be the part of the appendices. This is the third one. So as far as the first, we can divide the total structure of an article, effective research article, into three. First, introductory part, second, main part, and third one is end part. And in the first part, we can say that title, abstract, and keywords, including authors. So it should be easy for, make them for easy indexing and searching. So you should give the title and you should give the abstract, you should give the keywords. That will be very much useful for indexing and searching. And it should be informative. It should be attractive. It should be effective. So these points should be kept in mind while presenting or writing your the first part. I'll explain in detail also. As far as the main text is concerned, we have introduction, methods, results, and discussion. So make your articles as concise as possible, because usually we are expecting 10 to 15 pages, not exceeding 10 pages, even if it is an empirical paper or research paper. So it should be concise as possible. Now coming to the title, The first and foremost important thing as far as our writing of research article is concerned, the selection of the title. So initially we thought of having how to write research paper or guidelines for writing research paper. So finally we ended up with this title, how to write an effective research article. That in this way we have to select. So this is, you can avoid some titles starting with a study of, because it is obviously a study. Okay, so not necessary to say that a study of, and one more thing we have, and this title will be probably the most important part of the article. Why I'm telling this, the reader will decide about whether to read it or not, whether proceed to read it or not, so based on your title. So, and another important thing, you know, it should be describe the phenomenon, and in short as well as informative. It should be short. It should be informative. It is not a 3 lines or 4 lines. It should not be 3 lines or 4 lines. Maximum of 1 line or 2 lines. Then you can avoid the title starting with a study of. And one more thing, a good title should always contain a fewest possible words. Adequately highlight the content of a research article. So whatever the title which I have chosen or selected, that should highlight the content of your research article. Always catchy title. So will be cited more. Then regarding the authors, so each author should have made some contribution. If it is a single author, no issue, they will take the entire responsibility. If it is two or three authors, usually it will occur in social sciences as well as a few sciences. In few sciences, even they have 5 authors, 6 authors. So if it is a joint authors, they all should sign. And all should take the joint accountability for the contents, what is presented in that article. So that should be very important for them. Then usually the first author is one who is having the major input to the study. Will always prepare the major part of the, or most part of the manuscript. So credit goes to the first author. It depends upon the, what we can say, that the article what we are sending. Even UGC, some other higher education bodies also is also assessing your article, your merit based on the whether you are a first author or second author. Some ratio is there. Then coming to the third point, abstract. So we are in the 3 or 4 points are very important in the initial thing. One is abstract. That is abstract here. It is nothing but it's a bird's eye view of what has been done.
So sorry to interrupt. You want to share the screen?
Yeah, I'll share it.
Yeah, okay. Sure. Yeah, thank you.
A bird's eye view of what has been done and the important findings will be the part of the abstract. So we can say it is an ambassador of your article. Abstract is an ambassador of your article. It should be in one paragraph, not exceeding 200 to 250 words. It should be very accurate. It should be specific. A clear abstract will strongly inspire and extend the desire of the prospective reader. So why I'm emphasizing much on abstract? So if you are browsing many articles, instead of getting the full downloadable format or open resource, if you're not able to get the open full article in downloadable format, we can go through the abstract. So based on the abstract, we can write the review of literature also. So that is why instead of full paper, many research scholars, they are reading abstract only. That is why you have to give much importance to this abstract. So I'll give the example also. Even different journals may prescribe different abstract format. It is better to go through the instruction for authors. So in the abstract, it should always consist of background of the paper. What are all the objective or objectives? Usually 1 or 2 objectives. It is not a research, PhD research. It is only an article. We can have 1 or 2 objectives. What are the methods? What are the research designs we are following? And what about the findings and the conclusion, etc. And don't use the phrases such as "this will be discussed." These kind of phrases we should not use in abstract. Further detail will follow. Don't use these kind of phrases, because abstracts are more likely to be accessible to readers than the full text article. Okay, so this is a thing I'm emphasizing. Many will go through the abstract. If it is convincing, if it is good, if it is related to your research topic, then we'll go to the full article. Then. Fourth aspect in the first stage, you know, keywords. This is also very important. If you're not giving keywords, it is very difficult to the research scholars for referencing. And here we have in this e-world, the keywords determine whether your article is found or not. Very easily you can find out. So if I'm doing the presentation on this topic, very easily you can find out through internet in this IT enabled technology. So 3 to 5 keywords are required for indexing and cross-referencing. It is always mandatory. So you should not give 10 keywords and all. Minimum 3, maximum of 5. Okay. Then the words usually convey the research studied. What are all the important concepts, methods, population, setting up the study. So your selection of keywords based on your article. You should not give general, too general. Articles. Say for example, commerce, it is not keyword. Management, it's not keyword. It is too general. At the same time, you should not give too narrow. So that means here, you can take it this one. Because if you want a very particular about the keywords, you can go through online and search in many articles how they are giving that keywords. Then we'll get an idea about it. Because giving the keywords is also a very important point. Okay, then this is a what you can say example what I have taken from the Elsevier journal. It was published in the year 2020. I have properly acknowledged here. It is taken from Elsevier journal. So corporate social responsibility and bank efficiency. So we have 3 authors and associated with it is from France. Then you see this area. This is the title. Simple title, corporate social responsibility and bank efficiency. So this goes whether CSR is improved, they improves the bank efficiency or not. It is international level paper. I'll tell the methodology and all about this. So I have taken as an example to explain how this title, then who are all the authors, this is the associated institution, then this is the article information you see here. Okay, so received on 7th October, received in revised form 19th October, because always the editorial board is there, and again it will go to the reviewers. Then sometimes editorial board may reject it. That I will explain in few in the next slide to come. Then accepted on 7th January 2020, and finally available online on 9th January 2020. So this is about the article information. You see the keywords here. So you compare the title, corporate social responsibility, title, bank efficiency, and data envelopment analysis. They have applied one analysis here in this research article. So they have given only 3. So it is very easy to the research scholar. If they are going for DEA, means this article will come under display. And if you want a bank efficiency, then this article will come. If you are searching by using the word corporate social responsibility, this article will come. So this keywords, selection of keywords and title, you compare it. Okay, so title is over, joint authors, so co-authors, first author, these 2 are co-authors, and this is about the article information, and this is about the keywords, and coming to the area called abstract, you see that, how they have given, just 10 lines, okay, so first 2 lines,
you want any help, sir?
No, they are asking some slides. They are not coming. That is why.
It was not shared. That's what I suggested.
Now it is shared?
No, sir. You just press screen sharing. Share screen.
1 minute.
Yes.
Now it's okay?
Yeah, press. Yes, sir. Yeah, fine, sir.
May I repeat once again? This is the agenda what I have taken today. And these are all the reasons, personal reasons, why we have to publish an effective research article. So it may be related to PhD or get funding and get promoted, etc. So as far as the publisher is concerned, the editors, reviewers, they won't consider about your personal reasons. They will see whether it is a quality paper or not. Then usually the beginners, they will find it difficult to write, how to write and how to start and what format you have to use, what is the journals we have to send, etc. This is about the introduction. So I have given the link also before selecting an article, you have to select the journal first and go through the instruction to authors and guide for authors. So you have Elsevier, the one example I have given. In the same line, we have so many points. We have then UGC CAR listed journals. We have this is the group one and group two journals we have. And I'll explain in the question and answer session if time permits about the UGC CAR listed journals. And this is a process we have submission of the new article journal, new journal title to the publisher, with the help of publisher and to the individual. And this is the general structure of a research article, title, abstract, and keywords. Dinesh, is audible?
Yes, yes, sir. Fine, fine.
Yeah, even in the presentation, slides is coming?
Yes, yes, everything is clear.
Yeah. Okay. Now, this is about the title, abstract, and keywords. This is the main part we have, this initial part. And main part, we have introduction, methodology, results, and a discussion. And in the end part, we have conclusion, acknowledgement, references, supplementary data. As far as our general structure of research article is concerned, we have title, abstract, author, and keywords. It should be make them these three or four easy for indexing and searching. It should be informative. It should be attractive and effective. And as far as the main text is concerned, we have introduction, methods, results, and discussion. So make your article as concise as possible. So not exceeding 10 pages. So this is probably the first, the title will be probably the most important part of the article, because readers will decide whether to proceed to read or not is based on your title. Because it should be short, it should be informative. Please avoid using a title starting with a study of, because it is already a study, okay? And you should highlight the content of the research article in your title. Usually the catchy title or better cited. So now with regard to author or authors, we have the single author means no problem. And if it is a co-authored means they should, all the authors should take the joint responsibility because they have made a significant contribution to the design, analysis, and the writing of the article. So that is why joint responsibility for its consent is very, very important. The first author will always do the major part of the work. That is a major input to the study and prepares the major part of the manuscript. Even the first author will send and communicate to the publisher. And this is about the abstract. Abstract here, we mean that it will give the bird's eye view of what has been done and the important findings. Your abstract will be an ambassador of your article. It is always should be in one paragraph to 250 words. It should be accurate and specific. So it will inspire, a strong or clear abstract will inspire the young readers, so whether to read it or not further. So you see that we have different formats. As far as abstract is concerned, we have different formats. It is better to go to the instruction for authors, what they are prescribing. According to that, we have to prepare your abstract. Okay, we don't have any standard format. It varies from publisher to publisher. Okay, so normally the abstract consists of the background of the paper, objectives, methods, designs, and results, and a discussion. So in the abstract area or in the abstract paragraph, don't use the word phrases such as this will be discussed, further detail will follow. So don't use these kind of phrases, because abstract are more likely to be accessible to the reader than the full text. Suppose, say for example, 100 people or 100 research scholars are taking up of abstract of your article, means only 10 to 15% will read your full article, because whether it is related to their field or not. So then only they will take up your article for further. Then keywords are very, very important here in the first thing, because the keywords always determine whether your article is found or not. This is very much useful for indexing and cross-referencing. So minimum of 3 keywords and maximum of 5 keywords, 3 to 5 keywords are required to your article. So the words usually convey the research studied or important concept, methods applied, even population. I have explained one example. They have applied some technique. That technique is part of the that keywords. So avoid making them too general. Say, for example, commerce management. So always, if you want any title or article related to keywords, so you can go to the online search. We'll get the exact keywords. This is now it is visible. Yes. This is about the title, corporate social responsibility, and bank efficiency. You see the authors, and this is about the article information. These are the keywords we have, and this is about the abstract. Okay. Now, title is Corporate Social Responsibility and Bank Efficiency. This is, I have taken for example. It is from Elsevier Journal. It's for letters published in the year 2020. So they have received a revised form and accepted and available online. This is about the article history. Okay. And these keywords, you see the title and compare the keywords. Corporate Social Responsibility, Bank Efficiency, Data Envelopment Analysis. They have applied this technique in this article. Okay. Now, you see this abstract. The first line, how it is. Second line, what they are using. In the third and fourth line, what they are using. And in the last line, we thus assert that some institutional assets that must be present for the positive impact on CSR and bank efficiency. This is a findings they have given. So they will tell about the background, about the objectives, about the period, about the methodology they have applied based on the international sample of 184 banks in 41 countries over the period of 2009 to 2015. That is, this is an empirical investigation whether it reveals that positive impact of CSR on bank efficiency. So this CSR is having the positive impact on the bank efficiency. This is a major findings of the research. And moreover, we further show that this relationship is contingent upon the institutional context. And we find that CSR has a positive impact on bank efficiency only in developed countries. So of course, we are going to see, we'll read it. So by, I have taken this one example. We have so many articles I have taken to show this is related to commerce and management and social sciences. I have taken this, how they are described this abstract. Now coming to the main text. So main text essentially, it will follow, it's a, because we have to follow IMRAD system. That is, which is the basic of writing a scientific paper or research paper. What do you mean by IMRAD? It is nothing but introduction, methods, results, and a discussion. So the author should answer the following questions. So to make the article more effective, why did you do? What did you find? And what does it all mean? These three questions should be answered in your article. And coming to the introduction. Introduction means, we mean that article introduction. It is not a presentation introduction. To place, to convince readers that the work is relevant for them. So we have series of questions. Answer a series of questions. What is the problem? Research problem. Are there any existing solution for that? Which one is the best? What are the limitations? How do you hope to improve or contribute to this? In this way, we have to shape your research article from general to specific. This is what we are expecting from the research article. Your introduction should be like this. Answer the following questions. So series of questions. So explain the purpose of your paper and how to plan approach the topic. So these two should be highlighted in the introduction part. And moreover, and how you have organized your approach to the topic, and conclude the introductory paragraph with your problem statement, with your what is the problem you have taken up for this research. Then, and the introduction is a broad beginning of the paper that answers three questions. What is this? Why I am reading it? What do you want me to do? So these three questions should be answered in this. Then, methods. So this is regarding the methodology main part that includes research design, the settings, the population studied, the sample size, what are all the inclusions and what are all the exclusion criteria. Everything should be explained in the methods. The time that the study was done, duration. So that is also clearly explained in this methods. What are all the instruments we have used to measure the outcomes based on your primary data as well as the secondary data. What is the process we have adopted to collect the data? Is it primary data? Is it secondary data? If it is a primary data, what is the sampling method we have adopted? Is it a problem sampling or non-probability sampling? And if it is a problem sampling, whether it is a simple random or stratified or cluster, etc., etc. If it is a non-random, we have judgment sampling, quota sampling, snowball sampling, etc. So there are so many data collection process. So the methodology should be very strong. Then only your paper will be a research paper or empirical paper. So even we are using some software to say SPSS, AMOS, etc. to analyze your data. And what are all the statistical tests we have employed to interpret the results? So everything should be explained in this part. This is the major crux of the your article. So if there is any lacuna or if there is any problems in this area, your article will not be accepted by the reviewers, editors, or even the research community at all. Okay, so you should be very clear about the methods. And coming now, we have applied. I'm not going to in depth about the what kind of statistical tools we have to apply, what is the sampling we have to follow, what will be your population, what will be your sample size. I'm not going in depth now because I am going to talk about what will be the general structure of a research article. Okay, and we have completed the crux of our thesis, that the methods. Coming to the results, it is based on your statistical tools what we have applied to analyze were both the primary as well as the secondary data. So it's the driving force of the publication results, because it will tell about what we have found and what we are giving new things to the existing stock of knowledge. So your research should add to the existing stock of knowledge. It should not be the same what they have other authors they have found or already it is in the stock of knowledge. So it should be new. It should add along with that new knowledge. Okay. So tell the story for easy and clear understanding of the readers. So you have to tell just like a story and about the results, summarize it. The following should be included, the main findings, not all findings, because what you are doing in PhD research is different. If you want to give the full data, you can give it in the supplementary data column, that's at the end of your article. So you give the main findings, that is findings from experiments described in the method section. So what we have, the tools we have applied in the method section or statistical point, that can be explained in the, that can be highlighted by applying this statistical tool, we got this result. So we have to highlight it. Then highlight the findings that differ from the findings in previous publications. This is the thing what we are expecting. So and so has found this, this is the result. Now, based on my findings, based on my experiment, based on my analysis, we got these results. In what way your results are deviating from the previous result? Or in what way your research is correlating with the authors who have already found the results or the existing stock of knowledge? So you have to correlate. So generally, this is we can do it in PhD research also, what we are doing. While writing the review of literature, we'll write nearly 50 to 100 review of literatures. But usually the research scholar, they want to correlate the review of literature in their findings. Say for example, 10th review of literature. So it is related to your PhD research. So they want to correlate with the findings of their own research. So if possible, you try to correlate the results, not all. So unexpected findings. Now, we are not expecting all the findings to be correlated. So if possible, you try to correlate with the existing results. So results of the statistical analysis also, we should explain. Mere statistical interpretation alone is not sufficient. There is no significant difference between this and that. No, beyond that, why there is no significant difference? Why there is a significant difference? So conceptual, that is the results we have to give then. And of course, we have figures and tables in the results column. So these are the very, very important aspects, the most efficient way to present the results, because captions must be detailed enough to make the figures and tables self-explanatory. So if you are seeing that particular table or the figures, it should give a clear-cut idea about what should be. So the no duplication of research described in the text or any other illustrations. So we should not give any duplication of results. You go through one by one, because you know very well one picture is worth a thousand words. So if you are giving in the form of figures and tables, that will give better results than in the form of line by line presentation of results. I'll give the example also how the article explanation for this. Then coming to the discussion part. So we have highlighted the total, that is summary of all the results, what we have derived from your statistical analysis. Now coming to the results part, here you can get the chance to sell your data. This is where your talent stands. Now, many manuscripts are rejected because of the discussion is weak. if your discussion, because we have a very good title, we have applied very good methodology, we have found some results, but we are not able to present it in a way what the research community is expecting. Okay, so we have to correlate it. So how do you how do your results relate to the original question or objectives? Because we have framed some objectives, some research questions. So based on that, we have to correlate that question and give the results. So we need meaningful interpretation. So all statistical interpretation we are giving, we have to give a meaningful interpretation for each of your results presented. So, and are your results consistent with what other investigator results, or are there any differences? This is what we are very particular about the findings also. So this, whether it is results consistent with the other investigator, or if there is any differences, or you have to mention what type of differences are there. So if there are limitations, we should also tell about in the discussion also, discussion area. Then does the discussion logically lead to your conclusion? So why? Because next two discussion, we are going for conclusion. So it will go, continuity will be there. Then in the discussion also, how a discussion page should be like this. It should have the summary of major findings, indicating the meaning and implications for the planners, policymakers, and other stakeholders. So your discussion, you will highlight the implications for the planners, policymakers, and other stakeholders. So the comparison is made with the existing literature, explain the exceptions, and clarify unsettled points. Suppose in previous research, one or two points may not be clearly explained. In your research, we have to explain it. So that is a way in which you have to present your article to the research community, to this world. Then state the strength and the limitations of the study. So of course, we have to tell. So we are going to take up one example. They have collected data from so many countries. So they have collected it over a period, and they have presented it, and they have applied one statistical tool. So we have to highlight these are all the strengths of this article. And if we have for each and every research paper, we have some limitations. So that should be highlighted. Then do not make statement that go beyond what the results can support. Do not suddenly introduce new terms or ideas. Okay, then. In the conclusion page, do not summarize the paper because already the abstract is for that purpose. Some people, you know, in the conclusion page, again, they will summarize it. We have taken this data, we have taken this title and methodology we have adapted. No, not necessary. So the abstract is for that purpose. We have already explained that abstract. Don't summarize the paper in the conclusion part. So include the major findings followed by brief discussion on future perspectives.
Hello, sir. So there was a small technical error, I guess, for the speaker, and he'll be joining shortly. Be joining shortly, just wait for a while. So until he joins back, just wait for a while. sorry for the interruption. The speaker will be joining shortly. So just wait for a while. He'll be joining shortly. So I request everyone just wait for a while. The resource person will join shortly. Just wait for a while. So everyone, those who are watching YouTube live, just wait for a while. The resource person is joining shortly. So in the meantime, we'll just play a small video. So in the meantime, we'll just play a small video. You can just enjoy those for a while. So it'll be motivating. So we'll kickstart the session again once he joins back.
Hello.
Yeah. Yes, sir. Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
There's some internet problem.
Yeah. Yeah. No problem. No problem, sir. 1 minute. Yeah. The resource person has joined back, so we'll be starting the session shortly. So he'll be the resource person is back. So we're just kick-starting the session shortly. You can share your screen, sir.
Yes. Now.
Yeah. Yeah. You can share your screen.
Dinesh, okay?
It's not yet shared, sir. Just
1 minute. 1 minute.
Yeah, yeah, please.
Yes, sir. Audible?
Yeah, it's audible, sir.
Ah.
But the screen sharing has not been done.
Wait a minute, sir. 1 minute.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yes. Now it's okay, sir?
Yeah, yeah, fine, fine. We can able to view, sir.
Yeah. Dinesh, may I proceed?
Yes, yes, sir. Please proceed, sir. Yeah. Yes.
So coming to the last part of the thing in this conclusion, This is don't summarize the paper. The abstract is for that purpose. Already we have explained it. So the include the major findings followed by the brief discussion on the future perspectives. You can highlight even the scope for future research. Also, we can highlight in your conclusion area. So coming to the reference, so cite the main scientific publication on which the work is based. So what is your reference style of writing? You know, reference resource management. Reference writing software we have. So referencing style of the journal. For this, you refer guide for authors. Yeah, detailed guide will be available. The style vary from different journals. We can use EndNote. You can use Mendeley. You can use so many other softwares which are available. So I'll explain it. Some journals require complete titles of the cited references. They want the full title. Even the spelling of the author names and the year of publication should be very clear in the references. So punctuation where you are using full stop, comma, semicolon, bracket, etc. Everything should be in this perfect order. So accuracy of all citation, because where you have taken, so the accuracy is always should be maintained in the reference. So your authenticity is based on your the references what we have given. So although citations and bibliographical references can be managed manually, we can manage it with the help of Microsoft Word editor. But still, research management systems or softwares such as Mendeley or EndNote are increasingly popular now because they enable to find, save, and share information very efficiently. That is the main plus point here. So we can suppose you are browsing today, and we can save it in Mendeley or EndNote, and we can retrieval is very much easy and possible if you are going for research management software called Mendeley or EndNote. Okay, so we can find the save the article, full article in that particular software, and we can retrieve it at any time. You can view, you, say for example, research we are taking maybe 6 months to 1 year. So writing an article. So during this period, it is always safe to use the research management software for writing your references. Okay, then citation and bibliographics are generated automatically according to your preferred citation style. So they will, you have author's detail, you have title, etc. We'll arrange it accordingly. Okay, preferred style, whether it is a APA style or Chicago manual style or MLA handbook, we have MLA management, that is Modern Language Associations, American Psychological Association, that I'll give in the next slide. So even Microsoft Word editor is also a useful tool for managing bibliographies. These are all the reference management softwares which are available. RefDP, Mendeley, we see that Mendeley, we have RefWorks, EndNote, etc. This is very much available, but Mendeley and EndNote, they are using it. RefFocus is also very famous nowadays. This is for your, these are all the links I have, what I have given here for a link to reference management software. So Mendeley is from Elsevier, EndNote from Web of Science, RefWorks from ProQuest. So just I am citing an example here, just link, famous link, what the research scholars or the professors are using to write the reference section. Then citation style, how to cite. So we have so many styles. I will take up one or two examples here, just what are the various citation styles which are available. American Psychological Association, APA method. This is a common method what you are adopting in social sciences. Then Chicago manual style we have. Then another one is, now it is in, another one is Chicago manual style. Third one is Modern Language Association. In the field of social sciences, particularly commerce management, widely used system is that of APA method. You see that popular citation styles, MLA, Modern Language Association, they are using English literature, foreign language, communication, religious studies, they are using it. APA method, ours is APA, we can follow psychology, education, business or economics, commerce, management, nursing, etc. Chicago manual, they are using history, artistry, fine arts, anthropology, philosophy, etc. In the same line, we have so many styles. So what type of style is prescribed by the journal? Usually APA method, ours is commerce or management, you will go for APA method. Even the publisher is also searching APA method. If it is English literature, they can go follow MLA method of writing references. So always safe to refer the guide for authors, what the publisher says, according to that, we can arrange the styles. Then, of course, it's a formality, acknowledgements. We have to acknowledge the people who have helped in the completion of your research article, particularly the advisors, you may be a guide or financial supporter. Sometimes the research article may be supported by some of the institutions. It may be of seed, but just like as a seed money, etc. Financial supporters, you have to thank our higher educational institutions, even the proofreaders, technical persons, and others who have participated in the certain substantial aspect of your research product, that we can acknowledge it. Okay. Then, this is a supplementary data or appendices, what we can give. If you are not able to give entire thing in the what we can call the main part, methods, results, and discussion, some of the statistical tables, it may not be possible to give it in the middle of our article. We can give it as methods. Or if you want to explain what method we have applied, what is the formula, what is the mathematical equation we have adopted, mathematical formula we have derived, everything can explain in the theoretical concepts, in the methods, and even some of the analysis we can give it in the appendices, even blank experiments, even in the science, they will give the experiments and other details in the appendices. They will precise it, they will concise it to 10 pages, and if you want to give additional data, they will give it in the appendices. Then, and before going for selecting the journal, so 1 minute, I'll give the article. This is the article what we have taken. Dinesh, may I share it?
Yeah, please, you can do, sir.
Yeah, is it visible now?
Yes.
Yeah. So this is the article what we have taken for explanation, corporate social responsibility and the bank efficiency. So this is what we have explained in the previous slides regarding the title, author, associated with the university, and article information, keywords, this area. This very area is very, very important. It is based on this article is based on the international sample of 184 banks in 41 countries. This is a key area what we are here. So abstract is like this. You see that introduction part, how they are writing. Okay. So first they will few lines about the regarding CSR, and the impact will be given, and who are all the authors will be given in their brackets. So these are all the references we have. And at the end of the introduction, so our paper proceeds as follows. Section 2, this is section 1, introduction. Section 2 presents overview of CSR in the banking sector and it develops the hypothesis. In the section 3, description of the data, control variables, and methodology. Section 4 discusses the results. Section 5 concludes, our conclusion we have. So they have given some summary of the paper in the introduction part. This is about the conceptual framework, a theoretical framework about what is CSR, what is bank efficiency, etc. Everything highlighted in the here and with the proper references. Okay. And this is the data what they have taken. You see that distribution across the countries. So they have taken samples from 184 banks. Okay. I think in the abstract they have mentioned about 41 countries. From 41 countries, they have taken 184 samples. I think in India, they have taken 12 samples. Okay. So they have developed some hypothesis also based on this. You see that H4, that is the CSR efficiency link is stronger in countries where stakeholders orientation is high. In the same light, they have mentioned four hypotheses totally. They will give the explanation paragraph followed by hypothesis. Explanation paragraph followed by hypothesis. This is a strong crux of the research article. And we have developed the research, that is a problem statement, hypothesis, etc. And how to collect, this will be given. Okay, 184 banks from 41 countries from 2009 to 2015. So unbalanced panel of 930 firm year observations we have. Then bank efficiency, they are explaining about the bank efficiency also. Inputs and outputs, they are explaining in this year. Then about the corporate 3.4, here this is the main area we have. So they have applied some statistical table also. I think this is a very simple table, or that is why they have given here in the middle. If you are not able to give it here, we can give it in the appendices. So these are all the control variables and the results section. This is about the main area about the article. In the results, they are explaining with the data, and you see the interpretation here. Okay, and this is another table for three or four tables. They are giving explanations. So this is about the results and the discussion. And they are in the conclusion page. You see that this is about the conclusion page. So they are not summarizing it here. They will highlight it. Okay. So about, and finally, even the future prospects. You see that as a result, future invocation could focus on specific CSR actions in order to determine more precisely what initiative and policies most directly impact on bank efficiency. They are giving option for future efficiency. This is the method what they are writing the bibliography, that is references. Okay, so you see that. So this. Original PPT. Yeah. Now we have the how to write a research article. That part we have completed. So now we have to select the journal. So each journal specializes in a specific area of research. Hence, its readership varies. We have to find out which journal. Okay, choice of journal can make a larger impact on your research, because if you are selecting a very good journal, it will reach to many audience. It will reach to the research community. Okay, so select two or three journals and shortlist it. So discuss with your guide and decide the journal and what journal we can go for it, and find out the journal submission criteria and format. Everything should be very clear. If you are going for Elsevier, we should know about the format and everything.
Do you want to show the PPT?
Yes sir.
Just close the PDF and then show the PDF. Close or minimize the PDF.
Wait a minute. Okay.
Not it, sir. Yeah, now your screen is, you need to put the PPT on.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
Now it's okay?
Yes.
Yeah. Now this is about the selecting the journal. Now we have selected one journal, so we are going for submission. So read the finalized article carefully. If you want, we can give it to your advisor. We can get your feedback from your colleagues, from the subject experts, and you can go for publishing. Then check the accuracy of the figures and captions what we have given in the article. Are the figures correctly referred to in the text? Get feedback from the advisors and colleagues. Make sure that the article is read by at least one or two colleagues who is not familiar with the specific work. Of course, they may give some ideas. Okay, so this is about the article submission. Usually, we'll provide a cover letter or covering letter to the editor along with a brief paragraph explaining or highlighting the importance of this work and what are all the names of the reviewers. That is also we can give it. So possible reviewers is also important part of your covering letter. Usually, your known people, they won't accept. Usually, unknown people. That we have a peer review, blind review, double blind review, etc. So based on that, some criteria, your article will be selected. Have all co-authors approve the finalization version of the article. We have to sign that copy document. Okay. Then submit the article online along with the copyright form. So this is the submission part. And coming to the, once the article is submitted to the publisher, now it is a duty of the editorial board to review your article. So many journals use a system of initial editorial review. Instead of straight away sending to the reviewers, they will have an editorial board, editorial review committee. They will screen your article, whether it is in the perfect order, what is prescribed by our publication. So whether the references, whether the results, everything is in the perfect order. They will very particular about the format. All the editors are not very expert in the all area. They are very particular about the format. They are very particular about the presentation of your results, etc., the method of writing, citation, etc., references. So editor may reject your manuscript sending for it review.
Yes, sir.
Okay, even without for review, they will send it, simply reject it. Why? Because it is a disservice to ask the reviewers to spend time on the work that clearly does not fit that particular journal. If your journal is not fit to particular the prescribed criteria, what is mentioned in the instruction for authors or instruction guide for authors, then the editors, first stage itself, they will reject your article. They will return your article because they won't send it for the to the next level. So editors wish to use the reviewers only for those articles with a good probability of being accepted. So if your article is having a very good probability of being accepted, then only your article will be sent for review. Then article accepted means very rare, but it happens. Congratulations. We'll share your joy with the department colleagues or with other research scholars. So now we have to wait for the page proof. So once your article is accepted, with revision or without revision, that is a secondary, they will recommend some revisions. Then in the second submission, they will accept it. We have to page proof it. We have to give your final concurrence. Then your article will be on online and in print. So this is accepted. So high probability of being rejected is 50 to 90%. Because don't despair, because it happens to everybody. Even for me also, some rejection is there. So try to understand why. Consider reviewers' advice. So reviewers here, the subject expert, what I have given, where is the lacuna, where is the limitation? So what the area you have to improve, what is the lacking? So be self-critical. Okay, if you are writing and accepting, if your article is accepted in one or two journals, in future, you can able to find out. So how the reviewers are reviewing your paper, we'll get an idea. Okay. Then if you resubmit to same journal, you should respond to reviewers and editors' comments. So they will give the reviewers' comment and editors' comments. According to that, it should be properly executed in our article if you are submitting the same article to the same journal. Okay. And if it is for another journal, of course, we can take the inputs from the reviewers and editors of the journal, and you can go submit to the next author, next journal. Then regard it as a new manuscript. What you are submitting is a new one. Again, you have to go it. Again, go to the procedure what we have explained in the previous pages. And if you submit to another journals, take the advantage of the reviewers' comments. They may review your paper for the other journals too. Suppose you are sending your article to Elsevier. Suppose if it is rejected, or if a reviewer has given comment, then if you are not sending the same article to the same journal, we can approach another publisher or another journal. Sometimes the reviewer, what we have reviewed for the previous your paper, maybe the reviewer for the another journal. So this will happen. So it is always safe, go and read guide for authors of a new journal again and again. Then what is authorship? Of course, we discussed in the initial part of our presentation. Usually the senior author will be the main author, the contact person for the publisher is the first author. Corresponding author here means we mean the first author. Ensures all appropriate co-authors are included on the paper because they are also contributed substantially. Ensures that all co-authors have agreed to the manuscript and its publication. Then, as far as the co-authors is concerned, all those who have made a significant contribution to the conception, even at the initial stage, design and execution, and then at the end stage, interpretation of the report and of the study. So to that level, we can include as a co-author. For namesake, we should not include anybody as a co-author. Okay, all authors need to approve the final version and agree to its submission for publication. Everybody should sign. If it is two authors or three authors, everybody should sign that copyright form, and you have to submit it to the publisher. Then all co-authors sign on the and return, take the responsibility, joint responsibility, and credit for the entire manuscript. And in the middle, change of authorship after submission are strongly discouraged. So some friction will be there after submission. So some may say that we are going to withdraw. So if this problem will arise, they won't change the authorship in future once submitted. Okay, this is about the queries. Regarding any queries, we can regarding this presentation, we can send it to my email ID, and we have WhatsApp number also. My email ID is drjsrinivasan@gmail.com. WhatsApp number 944-355-7652. And if you want this PDF presentation in the PDF, this PDF format is available with the organizers. Already I have sent it to the organizers through email. And if you want, we can get it. And this is my contact details. And every ending is really just a new beginning. This is my thing. Thank you for listening. And if you have any queries, we'll go to the question and answer session. This is a feedback link. I'll give it to you at the end of the session.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much.
Yes, Dinesh.
Thank you so much, Dr. Srinivasan, for a wonderful presentation. Yes. And we have more than 400 people are watching live in YouTube, and around 70 plus people are watching in Zoom. And we have more views, so I'll be updating you with views. And our yesterday's program in of the Maradur Kesari Jain College got around 4,000 views until now, the first program. And today, I think it will be more by end of the evening. And thank you for all the YouTube viewers and the Zoom viewers for passionate listening. And thank you, Dr. Srinivasan, for explaining each individual points very effectively. And I request Dr. Nitya to take out the session for Q&As. There will be a lot of questions in YouTube, and there are a lot of questions in Zoom also. You can just facilitate the question and answer session, Dr. Nitya, ma'am. So there was a question, Ms. Dr. Nitya.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Yeah, ma'am. Please proceed with the.
Good afternoon to everyone. It's my pleasure to welcome you all once again for the question answer session of this wonderful webinar on how to write an effective research article. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much for your wonderful presentation. We have received a lot of questions from our in our chat box, both in YouTube as well as in Zoom. So we want to ask some few questions which is very important, and many people asked in chat box. The first question is, sir, what is the difference between conceptual paper and research paper?
Yeah. Dinesh, may I answer the question?
Yes, yes, please, sir, please.
Yeah. So it's a wonderful question because the title is how to write an effective research article or research paper. We have another paper called a conceptual paper or concept paper, or we can call it as non-empirical paper. So this conceptual paper usually reflects an issue that is of interest to a writer. The paper, conceptual paper, provides an opportunity to the deep discussion about a specific issue. So for example, here the concept paper may advocate for certain ideas or policies to be followed. So it is a non-empirical paper, just to find out something. Specifically, even the scientific disciplines we can take grow from new concepts, ideas, even theories, and expert opinions, not just data. So conceptual scientific disciplines grow from concept only, not just from data. That is the important point. But conceptual papers are the hardest kind of scientific paper to publish. Even the conceptual paper does not present original data, but it must be present an original concept. They are focusing much on concept, but in empirical paper reports are the research conducted by the author or authors. It is a report on a research conducted by the author or authors. So research can be based on observation or experiment. Okay, so another way we can put it, that an empirical paper is a research article that reports the results of the study, that uses the data derived from the actual observation or experimentation. We can take a best example, qualitative research. If you want to seek to establish a causal relation between two variables, so we can go for qualitative research. In the same line, we have empirical papers. So just to find out something, we can go for conceptual paper. It is a non-empirical paper, so not supported by many data. But here in the empirical paper, we have methods, we have rigorous methods, systematic methods, statistical analysis, followed by findings and conclusion. Nitya, ma'am?
Yeah, Nitya, ma'am, you can unmute yourself and then ask question.
Sir, thank you very much, sir. Can you hear my voice now?
Yes, yes, yes.
Yes, sir. Sir, the second question is, what is indexed journal?
Okay.
What is indexed journal, sir?
Okay. Right. So why you are very particular about the publishing your article in indexed journal? First, you should know what is indexed journal. An indexed journal is one that is indexed in various databases. Say, for example, Scopus indexed journals, Google Scholar. We can take an example also, that Google Scholar, Elsevier, Willi, Medline, EBSCO. These are all the databases which are available. So if your journal is indexed in these databases, that is called indexed journal. So if your journal is indexed, means that will give the reflection of its quality. If you are publishing in the indexed journal, it is always a quality paper. Okay, so indexed journal is nothing but, so indexed in various international level databases. Say, for example, Scopus indexed journal, Google Scholar, Elsevier, EBSCO, etc., etc. Nithya ma'am, clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is very clear. And thank you. Next question is, could you elaborate on UGC CAN-listed journals? Is it mandatory to publish in UGC CAN-listed journals? Asked by one of the viewers.
Yeah, I have the details about the UGC CAR listed journal. So a public notice was issued by, may I take 2 or 3 minutes for this question? Because it's elaborate.
Yes, sir. Yes,
yeah.
Sir.
A public notice was issued by the UGC on 28th November 2018 to announce the establishment of Consortium for Academic and Research Ethics, CAR. Consortium for Academic and Research Ethics, CAR. To carry out the mandate. So quality mandate for Indian academia. This is a mandate. To carry out this mandate, a consortium was established, and that consortium will tell about the some objectives they have to promote quality research, academic integrity, and publication ethics in Indian universities. And to promote quality, high quality publications in reputed journals that would help in achieving the higher global ranks. These are all the some of the objectives of UGC CAR. What is the need for this UGC CAR list? You know very well what are all the problems we have faced for the past 10 years or 20 years. So there are so many other journals, dubious, predatory journals, etc., etc. So that is why we need some UGC list, the CAR list. They have given the list of journals. So the scope of UGC CAR list, you know, UGC CAR has undertaken the responsibility of preparing the UGC CAR reference list of quality journals. So they have highlighted in group 1, group 2, a list of Indian journals, especially from disciplines of arts, humanities, languages, culture, and Indian knowledge system, is being prepared and updated quarterly by the UGC CAR listed journals. It is called UGC CAR Group 1 Journal. And in UGC group list, that is UGC list group 2, only two groups now. Previously, it was 4 groups. Now it is only 2 groups. In the second group, it includes journals from all disciplines indexed in globally accepted databases, such as indexed in Scopus, indexed in Web of Science. In the Web of Science, we have Arts and Humanities Citation Index Source Publication, Science Citation Index Expanded Source Publication, and Social Science Citation Index Source Publication. Everything comes under Web of Science. So we can simply call it as, in group 2, journals from all disciplines indexed in globally accepted databases such as Scopus or Web of Science. It is in group 2. Group 1, group 2, we have to go and register yourself and get the things done. Select the article from group 1 or group 2. Sorry, select the journal from group 1 or group 2. Based on that, we can submit your article. As far as UGC CAR is concerned, UGC Empowered Committee is there. Executive Committee, Empowered Committee is there. And UGC CAR Council members are there. In the UGC CAR Council members, they have some statutory councils, academicians, government bodies in social sciences, humanities, etc. There are four universities under UGC CARE universities. One is Jawaharlal Nehru University for Northern Region and MS University of Vadodara, Western Region, University of Hyderabad for Southern Region, and Tezpur University for Assam, Eastern Region. So we have separate cell called UGC cell for journal analysis at Savitribai Phule University, Pune. We have a separate cell called UGC cell at SPPU that we can see in the website. So that center is called Center for Publication Ethics, CPE, Savitribai Phule Pune University, to create and maintain UGC CARE list. Infibnet Center Gandhinagar is serving as a supporting agency for that. So we have two lists, UGC list group one, UGC CARE list group two. So every quarter they will update the articles. They may withdraw some of the journals from the list. They may include new journals in the list. So it is always safe if you are going for publication in the month of January, better to go and search in the UGC CARE list journal, whether it is included in that your journal, what your selected journal included in the UGC CARE list. Then credit will come. Sir, we can ask whether, is it mandatory to, of course, if you want to proceed with that PhD work, or if you want to go for promotion, so they are expecting some quality journals, quality articles, quality journals without to publish. Okay, Nithya ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. The next one is, many people have a doubt on it. What is impact factor? How it is calculated? And the next one is, what is high index? How it is calculated?
Yeah.
Sir, one second. Shall I ask, sir?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, sir. What is impact factor? How it is calculated? Okay. And many people asked about, what is H index?
Okay, right.
How it is calculated?
Right. So the impact factor of any journal is a measure reflecting the average number of citations to papers published in that journal. We have formula for that. I think it will take a time to explain that. Based on that formula only, that impact factor is calculated. It is nothing but reflecting the average number of citations to paper published in that particular author, particular journal. The indicator measure, impact factor, is just like an indicator. Relative importance of journal within the scientific field, or with the journals with the higher impact factor deemed to be of more importance than with the lower ones. If you are publishing your article with the higher impact factor journal, then it is a credit. So we have the formula also. That's not available in our, at present, it's not in the my file. I will explain it. So based on some calculation, they will arrive the impact factor. One thing. Then, what is the second one? H index.
What is H index, sir?
Yeah. It is found by Harish Index. That is, which was introduced by George E. Harish in the year 2005 as a way to quantify the productivity and impact of an individual author. Suppose if you want to find out the H index of one particular professor, we can go to some databases in the Google Scholar. We can go and find out the H index value. So if your H index is a count of largest number of papers, how many times your paper is cited by the number of research scholars. So you can say that H index is simply a count of the largest number of papers from a journal or author that have at least H number of citations. Say, for example, if you are having 10 citations for your article in a year on an average, so your index is based on that. Your index is 10. So we can go to the Scholar, Google Scholar or Scopus. We can find out the H index.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, can you spend some more time with us for two more questions, sir?
Yes,
sir. Yeah, sir. Thank you. Sir, many people asked about one important thing. While they are publishing their papers and articles in any UGC CARE list journals, at the time of publishing, it was listed. Okay. After that, they are removed from the UGC CARE list.
Yes.
So, in such a case, what will be the impact of the particular paper?
So this problem,
and how we are going to calculate it? Whether it will be valued or not?
Yeah, I got your point.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Yes. So at the time of sending the paper, it was in the list, UGC CARE listed GIST. At the time of publishing also, it was in the UGC CARE listed journals.
Yes, sir.
But after 1 year, it was not in the list. Okay. Now we have taken a printout of all reference. So at that time, it was in the CARE list. So after 1 year, it was not in the list. So if you are publishing your paper in the UGC CARE listed journals, we want backup. That is the reference for all your works, what we have done. Why this problem has come, you know, in the initial stage, now only that UGC empowered committee, that universities has given the assigned task. Previously, in the initial stage, the task was assigned to the vice chancellors of the respective universities. So they will recommend some journals to the UGC for inclusion in the UGC CARE listed journals. You know very well. At the initial stage in the year 2019, January,
yes,
so many journals, even regional journals, college-based journals, university-based journals, everything is was included in the UGC CARE listed journals. Now, it is not finding a place. So, based on the quality, because they have appointed a separate empowered committee, screening committee. That is why I have shown that one process, you know, how they are selecting the journal. Based on that, may I show that 1 minute.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. No problem.
Yeah. So, can you be able to see this?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Definitely, yes.
Yeah. Submission of new journal. You see the procedure now. So, first publisher or the individual, first protocol, basic information about the publisher we have to give, about the individual we have to give. In the second stage, IQAC cell of any college or university has to recommend to them, to the UGC. And we have IQAC cell of the UGC CARE universities. We have 4 universities. No, they have a separate IQAC cell. They will go and finalize it. They will assess your criteria and everything. This is protocol 2. And third protocol, UGC cell for journal analysis. They have a separate analysis in the Savitribai Phule Pune University. So they will assess. In the third, this is comes under the third protocol. And finally, the empowered committee has to approve that particular journal. So it, then only it will come in the UGC CARE listed journal. This is a screening process they are adopting now. Previously, on the basis of the recommendation from the respective universities, they have included. Almost now it is very clear. Now the path is, I think in future it won't come. In future it won't come. So now it is regularized. In future it won't come. We can select the journal now. We can go to the website, register it, and select the journal and publish the article. So in the mid period, you know, it is a transition period, we can call it as. So we, if your paper already published and included in that particular journal, means we can keep it as a record. That is value. That is eligible. Okay, even till now.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. And one more important question: what are the main causes for rejection for paper in a research article? What are the main reason for rejection of a research paper in any journal?
I explained it that nearly 50 to 90%, there is a high probability of rejection. Okay.
Yes,
so it happens to everybody, because first thing, whether the paper is in the as per order prescribed by the publisher, means it's okay, accepted. It is not as per the format or the rules or regulations as given in the guide for authors. Say, for example, if your reference style is not prescribed by the publisher, it's not as per the as per the prescription of the publisher, then it will be rejected. And the quality or content of the paper is also taken into account. Okay, then if the quality or content is not up to the mark, then your paper will be rejected. And if you are giving the same content, okay, not new, nothing new, then your paper will be rejected. Okay, there are so many reasons: format, the style of writing, references, or straight away they won't reject your paper completely. If if editor is rejecting, means it is not up to the mark. If the reviewers is giving comment, means there will be a high probability of being accepted. If you cross the editors, then if you go to the reviewers, means suppose we'll get a success. Definitely your paper will be accepted with some revision. So there are so many reasons for rejections. One is not as per the format, is the results are weak, the sampling methodology is weak, you have not discussed the results properly, you have not highlighted the points by giving graphs and tables, etc., etc. These are all the reasons why your article will be rejected by the publisher.
Okay sir, thank you. Next one is one general question, sir. What will be the job status or scope for the young researchers in the ICT enabled teaching and learning process?
Yeah, it is a general question. I think
yes,
in
sir.
This ITC enabled teaching learning process, you are asking the job prospects or job status?
Sir, job status or scope. Yeah,
okay. So the traditional method of face-to-face teaching cannot be replaced by this ICT enabled teaching. It is only a supplementary. We can call it as a teaching aids. That's all. It will supplement the one-to-one or face-to-face teaching. So we cannot replace this face-to-face teaching. But many young teachers are having the fear in their mind that whether there is a scope or possibility or probability of getting job. Because I will give you the best example. In the UGC website, if you are going to the UGC website, they have digital initiatives. It is not in 10 years before. Now we have Swayam platform. We have UGC MOOCs, e-Pathasala. That is for gateway to all the PG courses. For all PG courses, they have already inbuilt material which is readily available in the UGC website. We have National Academic Depository. We have All India Survey on Higher Education to collect data from the respective institutions. We have Swayam Prabha. Swayam Prabha is nothing but free DTH channels for education. At present, I think to my knowledge, 32 DTH channels telecasting high quality educational programs 24/7 for 365 days. So, even in one website, we have this much amount of information. So what will be the future job prospects? Who is preparing that material? Who is preparing that e-content? Who is preparing that video content? Teachers. So to my knowledge, definitely there is a scope. There is a job opportunity for the young teachers, that too, those who are having very good knowledge in the computer, that is ICT enabled technology. So if you are not able to cope up with this present situation, this pandemic is unexpected one. So now we are accustomed with this Zoom meeting or YouTube live streaming or Facebook live streaming, etc. So it is inevitable, unavoidable. In the same line, in future also, we need some technology. I'll put it in another way. So when the computerization was introduced in the banks, so there are a lot of non-acceptance from the bank employees union. Why? So they will replace the computers, will replace the humans. So people say that one computer can replace 5 or 6 people. No, not like that now. So now without computers, no banking. Without internet, there is no bank. So we have accepted. In the same line, teaching also we have scope, because we need people for translators. Suppose we are preparing one material in English. We want translators. We need translators to translate in Tamil, to translate in English, to translate in Telugu, etc. So we need translators. We need quality teachers. We need teachers to develop e-content. We need teachers to develop video lectures, etc., etc. Still, we have very good scope for young teachers, provided if they are capable of, or we can call it as techno-savvy. Okay, technology-oriented, if they are good, definitely. They have a bright chance.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Nitya, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. And one last question, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir. Is it possible to retry the UGC care list of approved journal already published here?
Sir,
is it possible to retry?
Retry means what do you mean?
Retrieve, sir. Is it possible to retrieve the UGC care list of approved journals published earlier?
That I have to check, ma'am, because okay. I'm not very sure about that. I have to check and I will explain. Okay,
okay sir.
because
sir, and one more thing, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Which plagiarism software is best? Mm-hmm. And when the citation increases, whether the plagiarism will reduce?
Okay, okay, right. So as far as the software is concerned, it is just like a database. We are using SPSS for analyzing your data. In the same line, we have so many plagiarism softwares. Turnitin, we have, it's high quality Turnitin. And the second one is, as far as the government, UGC is recommending Urkund. Urkund software is recommended by the UGC. I think they are going to install in all universities, Urkund software. I think there are so many free softwares which are readily available. I think, to my knowledge, we are using Grammarly. There is another software, Grammarly we have. There are so many softwares which are available. We can take this Turnitin, Urkund, Grammarly. These three we can take. Okay. Yeah. And you should be very careful. If your university is using Urkund software, before submitting your PhD thesis or article, if you are using the same software, means then it is 100% plagiarism will come. Okay. You should be very careful while using the plagiarism software. We have some options by removing or deleting that. It can be. And another thing, what we have asked, citations, you know. Now the method of writing review of literature is different. Initially, we have written just like a paragraph. Now we are using it in a table format. Even the foreign examiners for PhD thesis, they are very much welcoming the way in which you are writing. So title, author, year of publication, what is the sample size, the methodology we have used, what are all the objectives, major findings, and results. This is the way in which we have to categorize it. So based on that, we can write the articles. I think, to my knowledge, it won't give much plagiarism if you are writing the review of literature like this. Yes,
thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Sir, any other points you want to discuss, sir?
Yeah, this is regarding, I think I would like to share one thing. I have prepared these slides only for the benefit of young teachers and research scholars. Of course, it may satisfy one or two assistant professor or associate professor or professors, but my focus is on the particularly the beginners, those who are in urge to. So there is a question mark whether we are capable or able to get the teaching post as early as possible at the age of 25 to 30. Of course, we can get it, because now we have so many self-financing colleges or government-aided colleges or government institutions are there, but we are not able to get the quality teachers. My humble request is, at least from one classroom, we need minimum 10 to 15% of the students should be of interested in the teaching profession. We need future generation teachers. Definitely, we have very good scope for teaching profession, particularly in the field of higher education, because it is expanding. Okay, this is one thing. Of course, we are going to focus on ethics in research. I think on Saturday, I'm going to present one webinar in ethics in research in DKM College, Bellu. So we should concentrate more on ethical way of doing research, even in PhD, even in article writing, even in publications. So you should go for ethical way of presentation. It is my humble request to the youngsters. So I think we may expect some quality papers in the future. Okay, even though number is not important, but the quality is very much important. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. In this moment, our MKJC College Principal, Dr. T. Balasubramanian, sir, want to give us regards to you, sir.
Yes,
ma'am. Few seconds, sir, please.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sir, thank you, sir, for your wonderful presentation. This is my personal thanks, sir.
Yeah, sir, thank you, sir. Thank you.
For your
now, live sessions are over, sir?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Live on YouTube now?
Yeah.
Yeah, yes, sir.
Thank you. And I have clarified many things with you, sir.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Regarding research and all, I have also made many questions through the media.
Okay, thank you.
Sir? Let's go to the valedictorian session.
Yeah, ma'am, sure. So thank you so much, all the participants, and thank you, Dr. Srinivasan, for answering politely for all the questions. And dear viewers, we have been posted the feedback link in the YouTube chat box and also in the YouTube comment box, which will be valid for next 1 hour. So those who are completing within the next 1 hour will be eligible to receive the certifications. So thank you, Mardur Kasri Jain College, for hosting this beautiful session. So we had a beautiful comments and beautiful support system in the chat boxes. So I've been posted the link in the live chat and also in the comment box, which will be valuable for 1 hour. So you're not worried. So it will be valuable for 1 hour so that you can able to fill that feedback link, which will be available for next 1 hour. So you can just go there, you can fill it. I request the management of Mardur Kasri Jain College to proceed vote of thanks.
Before that, may I take 1 minute?
Yes, Dinesh? Yes, sir, please.
Yeah, I thank the organizers, particularly Nitya and Ashalakshmi, for showing interest on me regarding this webinar and initiating me to go for this. Initially, I hesitated to go for webinars and other things because I'm interested in attending so many international webinars. So these three people, Ashalakshmi and Nitya, has made me to come to this stage. So we discussed so many things regarding the what topic we have to give. Finally, we ended up with this topic. I thank particularly Dr. Nitya and Dr. Ashalakshmi, Vice Principal Madam, Dr. Inbal, Ma'am, Principal Sir, and the management for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Particularly, I thank Dinesh for doing wonderful job by coordinating all the people. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much, sir. So I request the management to go for a vote of thanks.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you. It's my pleasure to welcome you all for the valedictory session of this wonderful webinar on how to write an effective research paper, research article, which is presented by Dr. J. Srinivasan, sir, associate professor and research supervisor. So thank you very much. So now I move on to the vote of thanks session. It gives me an immense pleasure to propose vote of thanks in this wonderful moment. First of all, I would like to thank Almighty for making this event a grand success. In this wonderful occasion, I would like to thank our management and Dr. T. Balasubramanian, Principal, and Dr. M. Inbavalli, Vice Principal, for giving permission to conduct this wonderful program and for their continuous support and guidance. Thank you all. Next, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to our honorable chief guest, Dr. J. Srinivasan, sir, associate professor and research supervisor, PG and the Research Department of Commerce, Rajeshwari Vedachalam Government Arts College, Chengalpattu, for accepting our invitation and spending this valuable time. Sir, thank you very much. It was very, very pleasurable moment to accompany with you, sir. Whenever we used to call you, without any hesitation, in the first thing itself we used to take, and whatever the things we want to discuss with him, he always open his mind and he gives his feedback in all the area, not only regarding this particular program, but whenever we have a doubt, it is very open to us to call our Dr. J. Srinivasan, sir, to clarify our doubts. So thank you very much, sir, for spending your spacious as well as spending your wonderful time and such an informative presentation given to us, sir. It is very, very, very informative and very useful to all young research scholars as well as to the faculty members of various disciplines. Thank you very much, sir. And next, I would like to thank Mr. B. Shaktimala, PRO, and all the heads of various departments for their continuous support, and they have encouraged their staff members to enroll and get benefit out of it. Thank you all. Next, I would like to thank the participants. Yeah, that is the only thing we have to see, because with the overwhelming response of the participants, we are very happy. When we have started registering, within one day, we received more than 100 participants who have registered. Till now, we are having more than 1,600 participants who are showing their interest to register and to hear this particular webinar. Thank you all the participants. We have received all over India. Actually, we have received this participants from all over India. So we are very happy that among the participants, you have shown your interest and you have for a wonderful participation in this wonderful webinar. Thank you all. Next, it is my pleasure to thank all our MKTST staffs for their participation and their showing their interest with full energy towards this webinar. Next, I would like to thank all the technical support members, especially Sudhakar sir, Karpada madam, Anandi madam, and all the members, Dinesh sir, everybody, for their wonderful technical support given to us. Next, I would like to thank diversity team and R&D cell team for showing their interest and organizing this wonderful webinar on how to write an effective research article. Next, I would like to thank Ms. M. Hastalakshmi, IQC coordinator, for taking wonderful effort for organizing this wonderful event. Next, I would like to thank all the souls who have contributed their wonderful time and effort for organizing this. And in this moment, I would like to thank Dinesh Gajendran sir for giving his wonderful technical support to make this webinar a successful one. Thank you one and all. Please kindly go to the feedback form and submit your feedback so that you can generate your e-certificate. The feedback form will be open till 1 hour. Next 1 hour. So I request all the participants who have participated in this webinar, please link, go to the feedback form link and give your feedback and get your e-certificate. Thank you all for your wonderful participation. Once again, I thank you, Dr. J. Srinivasan sir, and everyone who have given the permission and who make this particular webinar a grand success one. Thank you all.
Yeah. Thank you, and please check the link. People are saying it's not working or not accepting the feedback. So please check the feedback, the feedback link.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So many people are commenting in the chat box. So please look at that.
Yes, sir. We are checking it.
Yeah. Yeah. So dear participants who are watching in YouTube, so please wait. If the link is not working, it will be troubleshooted. So it will be troubleshooted shortly. So please wait for a while. So it will be getting troubleshooted. If the college management, if please look at the link. If there is any wrong link or any problem in the link, so please submit the link again in the YouTube chat. So it will be helpful for the participants.
I request all the participants, please stay back for few minutes. Please stay back, we are checking the technical issues. Actually it has worked for the few minutes before, but now it's stopped. Let us check, please. I request all the participants kindly wait for few minutes so that we can solve that particular problem. I request the participants, please go and check. Now it's working. The feedback link is working. Kindly check. I request all the participants, please go and have a check on it. Now the feedback form is working. Kindly check. If there is any issue, please comment in the chat box.
Dear participant, now the link is working, so please go to the link and submit again. Do not worry about the rank, do not worry about the answers or scoring system. Those who submit the feedback form will be receiving the certifications. Do not worry about any scoring systems. The link is working now, so please go and submit. It will be active for next 1 hour. So do not worry about the scoring system. It will be small technical error.
Yes.
So those who are submitting, you will be receiving the certifications.
The technical error has resolved. Now it is working. I think many participants, they are giving in the command box that it is working.
Yeah.
We are very happy that it's working. I request all the participants to submit your feedback within 1 hour. The feedback link will be open the next 1 hour. After that, it will not be accepting the responses. So I request the participants, kindly submit your feedback within 1 hour so that you can receive your e-certificate. Shall we close?
Yes, ma'am. Shall I stop the live?
Yeah, sir. I think it's.
Yeah.